Digital Marketing Quick Start Guide, the simplified beginner's guide to developing a scalable online strategy, finding your customers, and profitably growing your business. Written by Benjamin Sweeney. Narrated by Duke Holm. Copyright 2002 by Clyde Bank Media, LLC. Production copyright 2022 by Clyde Bank Media, LLC. Please note that your purchase of this audiobook includes a downloadable companion PDF containing all the figures and visual aids referenced throughout this audiobook. Your purchase of this audiobook also includes free lifetime access to the Digital Asset Vault, which contains supplemental resources that enhance the content of this audiobook and maximize the value of your purchase. We highly recommend accessing the companion PDF and digital assets for the best listening experience. Visit www.clydebankmedia.com/digitalmarketing-assets to access the vault and download your companion PDF and supplemental materials. Introduction. Quote, "Business has only two functions, marketing and innovation." Peter Drucker. The lights are on, the door is unlocked, and you're open for business. Or you've paid your hosting fees and your inventory is listed on your e-commerce site. Your gym, bar, flower shop, or dog walking service is ready to do what it does best. You just need one more thing. No matter the shape, size, or flavor of your business, you have one burning need above all others: customers. A business's need for customers is a tale as old as time. The specific methods by which those customers are found, enticed into parting with their money, and convinced to come back for more have varied throughout history. But one element remains constant: the human element. Digital marketing tactics are the latest in a long line of commerce and exchange techniques that stretch back to trade caravans and the earliest of human settlements. This is a book about people. In it, we will discuss reaching people, understanding their needs, communicating with them, and providing them with value. Maybe you're a new entrepreneur who needs to stand apart from the competition, but you only have a small team and modest resources. Or maybe you've been in business for years and are afraid that the opportunities provided by digital marketing are passing you by. People who know nothing about marketing or digital tools will find tremendous value in this book, as will marketing students, veteran marketers, freelancers, entrepreneurs, managers, decision makers, and influencers. The truth is that digital marketing has, well, a marketing problem. For too many people, digital marketing is perceived as complex, expensive, and bewilderingly technical. The idea that digital marketing is a black box is reinforced by marketing agencies that need their clients to outsource marketing, by legacy media outlets clinging to advertising dollars, and by marketing coaches who have high-ticket courses and seminars for sale, to name just a few. In reality, modern digital marketing methods are intuitive, user-friendly, cost-effective, and more accessible to businesses of all sizes than ever before. Put bluntly, there is no better way to put your message, or product, or service in front of more people for a lower price. Why digital marketing? What sets digital marketing apart from other marketing avenues, above all else, is scale. Imagine it's 1940, and you've hired an army of copywriters, printers, and illustrators to push out print ads, radio ads, and mass mailings, only to see the first television ad beam directly into consumers' living rooms in 1941. Incidentally, that first commercial cost $9, upwards of $165 in today's dollars, and was a spot for the watchmaker Bulova. Fast forward to 1955, and total TV ad spending surpasses the $1 billion threshold. For savvy marketers, television was a revelation. Everyone wanted a TV in their home, and in short order, the same people that marketers across the country wanted to reach were spending more and more time looking at their TVs. Reaching people at scale was never easier. Today, Google's search engine processes more than 40,000 search queries every second of every day on average. Facebook has 2.89 billion monthly active users, over a third of all humans alive right now, and more than 2 billion emails find their way to inboxes around the globe daily. The sheer number of smartphones, computers, and always online devices presents marketers with that same revelation of TV in 1941, but at a scale that's so large, it's hard to wrap your head around. In fact, in much the same way that cell phones are just called phones now, digital marketing is so ubiquitous in our lives and so integral to the ways that businesses reach customers that it may as well just be called marketing. So why digital marketing? Digital marketers have the ability to reach truly massive audiences in the blink of an eye, at a cost that is much lower than that of traditional marketing methods. Digital marketing tools have enabled small businesses that would otherwise have languished in local markets to go global and deliver value to customers who may never have heard of them otherwise. Artists and craftspeople with even a minimal understanding of and investment in digital marketing tools can find, connect with, and sell their work to patrons who otherwise would never have realized they existed. However, digital marketing need not be global to be effective. Local businesses that use the same digital marketing principles outlined in this book can stay relevant in the minds of dedicated customers and deepen their connections to the community around them. One of the other aspects of digital marketing that makes it so attractive is how measurable the results are. Sure, a billboard by a busy stretch of highway may be seen by thousands of people, but how many of them act as a result? No one knows. There are imperfect ways to measure the effectiveness of traditional advertising, but they pale in comparison to the precision of digital marketing with its ability to account for each dollar spent. Armed with unique insight offered by digital marketing, marketers can see what works, what doesn't, and how they can tweak their efforts to reduce marketing costs even further. Digital marketers reach prospective customers where they are spending their time: on their phones, on their computers, on social media, in their inboxes, and with the content they consume. Additionally, given the wealth of information and metadata that we generate in our travels around the internet, digital marketers can learn more about their target customers, uncover new prospective customers, and track their responses to marketing efforts in near real time. Marketing in digital spaces also opens up the conversation in ways that are new and exciting for businesses. Marketing in the 21st century truly is a two-way conversation. Not only are companies learning more about their customers, but their customers are learning about the businesses they patronize. This two-way exchange increases brand loyalty and personalizes brands in ways that eluded marketers in the past. Plus, there is no better insight into customer preferences and needs than a conversation directly with the source. Why I wrote this book. Clydebank Media was founded in 2013 as a digital-first publisher. We're a book publisher, of course, but from a business model and marketing perspective, we're also an e-commerce brand. Clydebank Media doesn't have a physical storefront. We don't have retail shelf displays or window dressing. Online-only stores are long past the point of being novel, but we mention the fact that Clydebank Media is online-only because that has been tremendously influential in the ways that we think about our customers, how to reach them, and the future of our business. As a result, our team was engaging with the world of digital marketing from day one. All the concepts covered in this book reflect my hands-on experience working with the world of digital marketing. As a startup with a focus on growth, we've tried everything at least once. The digital-first nature of our business means that if we're not making money with digital marketing, we're probably not making very much money at all. Whether you are a digital-first business like we are, or you have a brick-and-mortar business, or some combination of both, you are likely aware that there is no escaping the digital revolution. Today's customers always have at least one foot in the digital world, and they have evolved into savvy digital shoppers. I wrote this book for a few reasons. It's easy to look back over the years and draw a straight line to our current success. The reality is that things are a little more complicated than that. We've had false starts, made decisions that later made us scratch our heads, and made outright mistakes that have cost us money. That's why I feel that my experience and what I've learned uniquely positions me to present an unvarnished view of the world of digital marketing. Where to start, what to do, how to succeed, and critically, what to avoid has been the story of our business for the last several years. I also wrote this book because I don't want anyone to be left behind. The business environment is a competitive one. So is the job market. When businesses thrive, so do the communities they serve. When job seekers have more marketable skills, their work is more rewarding, and they can live more comfortable and fulfilling lives. The rise and ubiquity of digital marketing hasn't just given professionals another line item on their resumes, but has also created entirely new career paths and job opportunities that didn't exist even a decade ago. In short, there is a wealth of opportunity available in digital spaces. Armed with the information in this book, you will be equipped to take full advantage of those opportunities. Who is this book for? While anyone interested in marketing can benefit from this book, there are some people who will find it particularly useful. Entrepreneurs, artists, and influencers. From wantrepreneurs to solopreneurs, and every kind of business owner or decision maker in between, starting and growing your business without an understanding of marketing principles and how to put them into practice in digital spaces will be a huge challenge. If you're an entrepreneur who is hands-on with your digital marketing efforts, this book provides a solid grasp of the fundamentals you will need to know to reach customers, grow your business, and make more money. Not just by running ads, but by creating holistic digital marketing campaigns, interpreting the results and feedback from those campaigns, and building on success to keep costs low and thrill your customers. Plus, as a primer on digital marketing automation, this book will teach you to improve the effectiveness of your marketing activities while keeping time and effort to a minimum. As any entrepreneur who is trying to do it all knows, the most valuable resource at your disposal is your time and attention. Automating your lead generation efforts, digital advertising, email follow-up, and more frees up time to work on improving and growing your business in other areas while saving time and money. Caution: planning to outsource your digital marketing efforts? Don't put this book down. Understanding digital marketing fundamentals means you are better equipped to work with agencies, freelancers, and other digital marketing outsourcing partners. Not only will you be able to better communicate your needs, but you will be better able to interpret the results and provide feedback for your collaborators. Today's entrepreneurs aren't just business owners. Creators and makers are finding that a mastery of digital marketing can make a world of difference when it comes to getting ears for their musical projects, eyeballs on their design work or art, and more ways to monetize their hobbies. Professionals and freelancers looking for a saleable skill. Digital marketers are in demand. The Bureau of Labor Statistics projects that demand for professionals with marketing experience will grow faster than demand for most other occupations. While there are still jobs in traditional marketing, today's marketing positions necessitate experience in digital spaces. The gig economy is also fertile ground for experienced digital marketers to succeed. Freelancers who find their niche in email marketing, social media management, search engine marketing, or pay-per-click management can develop a healthy business solving digital marketing problems for their clients. If you are looking to learn digital marketing to gain employment, either as a freelancer or with an agency on a more permanent basis, this book will give you an advantage in the marketplace. Students and marketers looking to expand their skill sets. Marketing students and business students owe it to themselves to build a strong digital marketing foundation. Likewise, marketing professionals who have limited experience with digital marketing concepts should start here to bring themselves up to speed and stay current in their field. If you are already a member of the marketing industry, don't worry. The digital ship hasn't sailed. If anything, digital marketing is easier than ever to break into and put into practice. How this book is organized. Digital Marketing Quick Start Guide is organized into three parts: Digital Marketing 101, Tools of the Trade, and Execution. Part 1, Digital Marketing 101, provides a catch-up opportunity for readers who are not overly familiar with basic marketing concepts. These concepts are fundamental to marketing activities no matter the environment, whether a billboard or a Facebook ad. This part of Digital Marketing Quick Start Guide serves as a detailed walkthrough of the basics of understanding what you're selling, who you're selling to, how to segment your market, and how best to set and achieve your marketing goals. Part 2, Tools of the Trade, gets down to business with the information you need about the tools that will fill your digital toolbox. We discuss at length websites, search engine optimization, or SEO, keyword selection, paid search placement, and pay-per-click, or PPC, advertising, social media, and email campaigns. These are the nuts and bolts that will power your campaigns and the relationships you have with your customers. By the end of Part 2, you will have a solid understanding of how different digital marketing tools fit together, which ones are the best fit for your marketing goals, and how savvy digital marketers use these tools in unison to power successful digital marketing campaigns. In Part 3, Execution, you'll learn how to take the tools covered in Part 2 and put them to work in a cohesive way. Use digital marketing tools to create sound marketing strategies, build your digital marketing funnel, assess and optimize campaigns, troubleshoot underperforming ads, and more. The content of the book moves logically from beginning marketing concepts to the fine-tuning of a campaign, but you can read and use it in any order that is most advantageous to you, though we don't recommend skipping anything. Chapter by Chapter. Part 1, Digital Marketing 101. Chapter 1. Digital marketing gets a lot of attention and is the focus of this book. But it's important to understand that digital marketing uses timeless marketing fundamentals that have been honed over decades. A crash course in marketing concepts explores the overall field of marketing, detailing the basic concepts and elements that guide all marketing efforts, regardless of where the message appears. This chapter will be particularly valuable for readers who haven't studied marketing or are not overly familiar with the basics of the topic. Chapter 2, Core Digital Marketing Concepts, outlines concepts that apply specifically to digital marketing as well as other business concepts, such as product design, process design, and strategic pricing. Chapter 2 dives into the importance of customer lifetime value and the differences between, and different uses of, earned, paid, and owned media. It also defines some of the marketing concepts that are used throughout the rest of the book. Chapter 3. Before you make the first keystroke of your first campaign, there are quite a few things to get squared away. In Who Are You Selling To?, you'll learn about market scope and identifying your target audience. We walk through the process of creating a customer avatar, understanding the customer journey, and how these concepts impact the decisions you'll make when planning and executing campaigns. Chapter 4, What Are You Selling? Introduces the all-important value ladder, a tool that helps you organize related products or services into a sequence and keep customers advancing, or ascending, through your product offerings to spend more and more. We explore how to use upselling and downselling tactics and how to craft an offer your customers will find difficult to refuse. Chapter 5. Like any business activity, digital marketing should be undertaken with concrete goals in mind. What are your objectives? We'll help you clarify what you're working to achieve, whether it's increased sales and profits, improved generation of leads, or the launch of a new product or service. Once you've identified your objectives, you'll rely on SMART goals to reach them. That is, goals that are specific, measurable, actionable, relevant, and time-bound. With a clear set of goals in mind, you are ready to move on to evaluating the tools at your disposal. Part 2. Tools of the Trade. Chapter 6. Coming in for a landing explains the importance of building a website that serves as a point of contact and enables you to stay in touch with visitors, and how to use specific pages, such as a landing page or a squeeze page, to convince visitors to take action. You'll learn more about the power of compelling headlines and copy and how to use various types of social proof to convert traffic into paying customers. Chapter 7. Capturing Traffic discusses how to use earned media to attract traffic to your landing pages. We will also take an in-depth look on how to use search engine optimization to capture organic web traffic from search engines like Google, along with how to create and deploy content strategically. Chapter 8. In Directing Traffic, you'll learn the ins and outs of selecting keywords to drive customers to your site, as well as how to track and analyze the success of keyword-driven advertising campaigns. Learn how pay-per-click advertising is used to drive traffic from everyday internet searches while keeping budgets in check. Chapter 9. In Social, we dive into the world of marketing and using social media and social advertising while smashing misconceptions about what it means to be a social brand. We also explore marketing via chat, ways to stand out in the competitive social media spaces, and driving revenue from social media. Chapter 10. The Money is in the List. In Following Up with Email, you'll learn why email marketing is still one of the most powerful tools in a digital marketer's toolbox. We break down how to build and get the most value out of a robust email list. Part 3. Execution. Chapter 11. Now that you have a firm understanding of the tools available to you, it's time to put them to work. Building a sound marketing strategy explains the importance of building a scalable digital marketing funnel. We also discuss how to use lifecycle marketing methods to advance traffic through the digital marketing funnel and turn traffic that has never heard of your brand into raving fans. Chapter 12. Digital Marketing Efficiency discusses the ways in which new and veteran marketers can get the most out of the tools and tactics covered in this book. The chapter also takes a look at the ways you can troubleshoot poor performance and use marketing automation to scale your marketing efforts with ease. Part 1. Digital Marketing 101. Chapter 1. A Crash Course in Marketing Concepts. Chapter Overview. Marketing Defined. A Review of Basic Marketing Concepts. The Marketing Formula Explained. The Marketing Mix and the Brand Positioning Matrix. Marketing is everything you do to attract customers willing to buy your products or services. Some marketing tactics are designed to make potential customers aware of your offerings in hopes of persuading them to buy from you. Others work by attracting your target market to your company so that you can sell them something. Marketing is different from sales in that marketing consists of the promotional strategies and tactics you use to convert someone from a prospect into a paying customer. That last step, where you negotiate when, where, and how the customer is going to hand over their credit card or cash, is where sales gets involved. There are two different steps in the process you'll use to make money in your business. Before we dive into the specific tools and tactics that digital marketers use to grow their businesses, it will be useful to revisit the basic concepts of marketing in general. You might wonder whether these traditional forms of marketing and their principles have been rendered obsolete by digital marketing. In a word, no. Traditional marketing is in fact more alive and well than ever before, while the methods of communication, tools of persuasion, and reach of marketing efforts are subject to the same breakneck pace as the development of technology, meaning they evolve and adapt too, the one constant is the human element. Marketers want to reach people. This is true whether they are going door to door or sending a mass email. The distinctly personal aspect of marketing, whether face to face or through a computer screen, has largely remained the same over the years. So, it's helpful to have that background knowledge before we get to the digital-specific stuff. In this chapter, we will review some of those foundational marketing elements and discuss their strategic role for marketing decision makers. Question: you may be asking yourself, can I just skip this section? This book is designed to be a helpful reference guide, so you can jump around if you so choose. But it is also laid out very purposefully. These concepts aren't strictly related to practical digital marketing, but they are critical to building a cohesive and successful digital marketing strategy, or any marketing strategy for that matter. You will use them in your first campaign, your 10th campaign, and your 1,000th. They are worth reviewing and keeping in the back of your head as you build your strategy from the ground up. What is marketing? The American Marketing Association, or AMA, defines marketing as the activity, set of institutions, and processes for creating, communicating, delivering, and exchanging offerings that have value for customers, clients, partners, and society at large. A more common way to think of marketing is as the collection of activities that businesses use to make it known that they exist, and to convince consumers that the business is likable and trustworthy enough to buy from, or at least to consider buying from. But marketing isn't just one activity. In practice, it is the management, coordination, and execution of a wide range of promotional activities and processes. These processes commonly include advertising, sales, promotions, market research, brand management, distribution, and public relations, each of which is a specialized discipline in its own right. Digital assets. To help you pull together all the pieces of your marketing plan from the outset, please download and fill out the Digital Marketing Strategic Planning Worksheet we've designed that walks you through developing your brand, outlining your offer, and choosing the marketing methods that will work best for your company as you read each chapter. You can find the worksheet with your digital assets at www.clydebankmedia.com/digital-assets. Because of their impact on revenue or sales, the activities that the sales and marketing department of a company undertake are absolutely critical. In many cases, the sales and marketing departments are an organization's primary point of contact with customers. Because of this, when a marketable entity communicates with a customer and vice versa, the outcome of this conversation is entirely shaped by the skill and sophistication of that entity's marketing department. Here, a marketable entity is any thing that can benefit from identifying, anticipating, and satisfying the requirements of customers. A marketable entity is commonly a company, brand, or organization. But just about anything or anyone can implement marketing techniques and practices. For example, self-marketing, now more commonly referred to as personal branding, is the practice of promoting a person or personality as one would a company or product. Similarly, political campaigns use marketing techniques and tactics to pitch candidates. Example: there are numerous examples of marketable entities that are not companies or products. Despite being on the cusp of his 70s, Sir Richard Branson is a veritable poster boy for personal branding. He is the founder of the Virgin Group, a multinational conglomerate owning a portfolio of more than 400 companies, including Virgin Atlantic Airline and Virgin Mobile Services. Branson himself does not shy away from the camera or social media. In his numerous media appearances, he is always cheery and smiling, projecting the image of someone who is open and relatable, despite being a man of considerable wealth. This perceived authenticity has been a distinct asset for Branson as an entrepreneur and businessman, and has been a key factor in why the numerous commercial brands his own personal brand is associated with have grown steadily through the years. For much of modern history, the conversation between marketers and customers was largely a one-way exchange. Billboards, catalog sales, circulars, coupons, TV and radio, etc., allow the opportunity for a marketable entity, such as a company, to present a message to an audience about its products or services. But that same audience, the customer, doesn't have a clear channel of communication through which to respond when presented with those messages. As you are already well aware, the advent of the World Wide Web has completely changed that dynamic. And now the conversation between marketable entities and their audiences is much more of a two-way exchange. Through social media, email, live chat, and phone, prospects and customers can reach out to brands or organizations directly. This shift has empowered consumers in ways that marketers never could have predicted, but have now come to embrace. In addition to providing simple feedback, audiences can amplify a message by sharing it with their followers, or they can rally others to a cause by adding their own commentary and stories, all at no cost to the marketer. There is a downside to this two-way messaging, of course. As audiences have become more empowered, they have also become more critical of companies and their marketing efforts, and rarely hesitate to severely punish missteps. Why is marketing important? No matter how sexy, exciting, new, or tech-enabled your product or service is, it simply will not sell itself. This is especially true if your potential customers don't understand how your product solves a problem they have or fulfills a burning need. Most important, even if your product was so compelling that every consumer snapped it up without a second thought, people's attitudes and preferences change over time. Marketing, digital or otherwise, is the way your company puts your product or service in front of customers, helps them understand why your offering is the best fit for their needs, and keeps your company abreast of changing customer preferences. It can be easy for entrepreneurs to develop tunnel vision when focusing on their products. After all, working so hard on getting one thing exactly right takes focus and dedication. But this becomes a real risk when it's time to look at the big picture. A build-it-and-they-will-come mentality is not only misguided, but it can have a serious impact on the success of an emerging company. The development of marketing strategy at the expense of product design and vice versa can result in wasted marketing dollars, last-minute product changes, and product launches without validation of true demand. In both product design and marketing strategy, focus on the needs of your target market and don't undertake one action without committing to the other as well. That is, don't develop a product and then try to find a target market for it. Let your market drive product development. We humans like to think our decisions are based on reason and logic, and, by extension, so are our buying habits and preferences. But the reality is that purchasing decisions are more often driven by emotion, and it is through marketing that savvy professionals aim to influence those emotional connections that lead to purchases. Although the end goal of marketing is a sale, there are numerous objectives that marketing can help achieve. Marketing reaches customers. The most straightforward use of marketing activities is to reach, meaning communicate with potential customers, and share your message with them. That message could be about a new product, a sale, anything you feel is important to share and helps you achieve your business goals. Reaching new customers, maintaining relationships with existing customers, and attempting to win back customers who have defected to competitors is the lifeblood of any business. Marketing provides customer clarity. Reaching customers is essential, but is only half of the equation. Knowing what to say to those individuals when you have won their attention is just as important. Today's two-way conversation between marketers and their audiences means that you can often identify exactly who is interested in your products and services. The more you understand the wants, needs, fears, and concerns of the people your business interacts with, the more effective you will be when communicating with them. Note: understanding who you're talking to and crafting messaging that resonates is classic marketing in a nutshell. Dedicated and diligent market research uncovers key aspects of the people who will become your target market, the people most likely to buy your product or service. But it also uncovers another group of people, those who aren't interested in buying what you're selling. There are many reasons we don't buy things. We may not understand how a product or service improves our lives or solves our problems. The price may be too high. The product may not be available where we shop. Or it might not be as good a fit as another product we already use. The list goes on. Identifying the type of people who don't have a need for what you are selling is important because your marketing efforts will be much less effective when speaking to this group. Marketing explains benefits. Though they are sometimes used interchangeably in casual conversation, the terms feature and benefit have very different definitions in the world of sales and marketing. A feature is a particular aspect of a product or service that provides value and differentiates it from others. A benefit is the value that a feature provides to the customer. For example, a tech-enabled feature on many new cars is the ability to make phone calls through a synced phone using voice commands. The technology that makes this possible is the feature. It provides value and differentiation. The ability to make calls safely, and in many states, legally, without looking away from the road is the benefit to customers. The most important thing to remember about features and benefits is that people buy benefits, not features. Features are necessary to produce the value, benefit that people will buy. But no one will buy a product based on features alone. A feature-packed product may be a true marvel, but if customers don't understand how those features translate into benefits in their own lives, they won't be interested. Marketing is the key to bridging this gap. As the saying goes, don't sell the steak, sell the sizzle. Example: a good way to think about the difference between features and benefits is to translate a feature into a "what this means for you" statement. For example, a car salesperson may say, "The newest model of this sedan includes wireless connectivity to your phone and recognizes your voice to enable hands-free calls through the car's speakers. What this means for you is that you can keep your eyes on the road and make calls safely and confidently." Marketing defines your brand. A brand is the sum of feelings, associations, and perceptions that people have regarding a company and its products. The concept of brand can be tough to nail down. Even the definition of what exactly a brand is can be a point of contention. A logo, for example, is part of a brand's image. But a brand is much more than a logo. Packaging and color palettes are part of a brand. But a brand is about more than just the way products are dressed, and it's more than just a mission statement. If a company is a person, then that company's brand would include their personality. Are they fun and enthusiastic, or serious and professional? Do they wear bright, sporty clothes, or do they dress more conservatively? Are they a person you think of when you want to relax? Or are they a person you would rely on for advice or help? These intangible elements that surround a product or a company coalesce into that company's brand. Branding, or the activities associated with refining and spreading brand elements, is a marketing function. A brand's perception helps customers connect with it and acts as shorthand for the experience those customers can expect. A well-defined brand can be a differentiating aspect between two otherwise similar products, or it can justify higher prices for products that are perceived as premium or luxury. Remember, a brand is the sum of feelings, associations, and perceptions. Any of these individual brand elements can have negative connotations as well. A brand that is seen as cheap, socially irresponsible, of poor quality or value, or otherwise objectionable will face an uphill battle when it comes to winning new customers and retaining existing customers. Marketing moves the conversation to the emotional space. A message that is tailored to speak to the exact wants, needs, fears, and concerns of customers is much more likely to hit the emotional points that trigger a sale. Earlier in this chapter, we touched on the idea that for most purchases, the decision to buy is an emotional one. Reaching customers, learning about them, educating them, and explaining what features mean to them, presenting a well-defined brand, culminates in the transition from rational decision-making to a more emotional commitment. The point at which logic gives way to emotion is known as effective override, and that point is when marketing is most effective. Different marketing perspectives. Now that we have established exactly what marketing is and why it is necessary, let's look at some of the traditional marketing elements and how they work in digital environments. Crafting an effective marketing strategy can be a daunting task. Fortunately, there are a few basic principles that hold true, regardless of whether you're working in a traditional or a digital space. Together, these principles form what is generally referred to as the marketing formula. Market. The market is the group of individuals you are targeting. For example, men and women between the ages of 18 and 33 in Los Angeles, or all the brick-and-mortar clothing retailers in the United States under 9,000 square feet in size per location. Subsets of those groups are called market segments. Media. Media, or the medium, is the channel through which you will be sharing your message with your market. This can include mass media, such as major broadcast television, or much more personal methods of communication, such as email, SMS texting, and in-person conversations. Message. The message is the content of what you want to share with your market. When marketers craft a message, it is always done with a goal in mind. What is the desired action that the market, your target audience, should take after reading the message? Do you want prospects to visit your new website? Stop by your new storefront? Are you reminding your market that you are open for business? What's the point of your communication, and what do you want your market to do? When the three aspects of market, media, and message work together in harmony, marketers find success. When one of the sides of the triangle is not a good fit with the others, marketing efforts begin to underperform and don't deliver satisfactory results. Synchronicity between market, media, and message is essential, as shown in Figure 2. As a marketer, or someone who has become a de facto marketer by virtue of being a small business owner or entrepreneur, how do you determine the best way to deploy your market, media, and message? The answer is strategy. All businesses have the overarching goal of profitability, but there are often objectives and steps along the way that can help ensure that the marketing tactics you use will yield optimal success for your business. Small businesses often focus more on growing their customer base and increasing the amount that each customer spends. Larger corporations often pay more attention to market share increase and maximizing the value of their product lines. Whatever the size of your venture, these strategic, long-term goals can be accomplished through careful implementation of the marketing formula. Let's look at some distinct categories of marketing that use different versions of the market, media, message mix. As we do, think about campaigns you have seen or have executed yourself. How do these marketing perspectives relate to different products or services? How do they relate to different markets or groups of people? Most marketing efforts can be divided into two overarching categories, outbound and inbound. Outbound marketing. Outbound marketing is the catch-all term for marketing that is disseminated or issued by a company or marketable entity. It is when the entity initiates the conversation with its target audience. This form of marketing is generally known as push marketing because it pushes the message out to the target audience, whether they are actively interested in hearing it or not. Traditional forms of advertising, such as print, radio, and TV, are perfect examples of push or outbound marketing. Digital versions include online pop-up ads, Facebook ads in one's news feed, and promotional emails. Inbound marketing. Inbound marketing is, as you would expect, the opposite of outbound marketing. It is marketing that happens in response to consumers who are actively seeking out a product or service. Inbound marketing is synonymous with the term pull marketing, because inbound tactics pull customers along a chosen path toward a purchase instead of reaching out to them. Giving away a free resource that solves a problem for a customer or writing an informative article that appears in search results are both inbound marketing tactics. In these instances, potential customers seek out a solution to a problem they are already experiencing, meaning they are primed to receive value from a brand that can put information in front of them. Figure 3 shows examples of common inbound and outbound marketing tactics. The advent of search engines, high-speed internet, mobile connectivity, and social media have radically changed the ways in which marketers think about and deploy inbound strategies. Once upon a time, inbound marketing was the sole realm of massive corporations. Marketable entities that had deep enough pockets to collect sufficient amounts of data about their customers and leverage their existing customer awareness. Moreover, to further boost awareness, they could deploy aggressive outbound campaigns as needed, which in turn set the stage for the generally more cost-effective inbound marketing efforts. Today, the ubiquitous, accessible, and cost-effective marketing tools that are available to businesses of all sizes are driving an inbound revolution in the digital marketing space. Still, no marketing strategy is complete without a plan to both push messages to customers and pull them to your business. You need to do both. Direct response marketing. Direct response marketing is a specific type of outbound marketing designed to elicit an immediate response or action from your target. This type of marketing is generally used with buyers who are aware of the problem a product or service solves and are much closer to making a purchase. A sales page, a promotional email or text, or a chat message that encourages the recipient to take action now are all examples of direct response marketing in action. There is no limit to the kinds of media that can be used for direct response marketing. But personalized, targeted media often generates the best results. As with all other marketing messages, direct response efforts use messages that are crafted with a purpose. In this case, the purpose is almost always made clear in the call to action, or CTA. A CTA is a request that your audience take a particular action, which is a step toward making a purchase. An email that is advertising a sale may end with the CTA, Shop Now, with a link to the relevant product selection. Or a CTA may encourage website visitors to start a free trial, make a donation, join an email list, or leave a review. As with any other strategic marketing elements, direct response calls to action should work in unison with the overall message and target market and should be appropriate for the delivery media. Example: a classic staple of the direct response approach to marketing is the sales letter. These long-form letters were traditionally written using persuasive language that was tailored to a very specific audience. Today's digital iteration takes the form of sales pages, persuasive emails, landing pages, and sales funnels, all of which will be covered in detail later in this text. Direct response principles work in conjunction with these and other inbound methods to deliver a 1-2 punch that thrives in digital environments. Inbound techniques bring in customers who know they have a problem that needs a solution, and direct response tactics are used to close the sale. Awareness marketing. Awareness marketing is the general term for marketing efforts that aim to increase brand recognition and awareness in target markets. It is a form of outbound marketing. Its goal is to encourage potential customers who may or may not be aware of your product or service to seek you out based on the solution you provide. Awareness marketing works well in conjunction with other outbound marketing tactics. But when used alone, it generally doesn't produce the results marketers are looking for. Frequently used in traditional, non-digital marketing, there are many examples of awareness marketing. The entire industry of out-of-home advertising is ideal for delivering awareness-based messages. Out-of-home advertising consists of billboards, banners, benches, city buses, and anything else that is visible when people are out and about. In the digital realm, awareness marketing takes those out-of-home principles a step further. Not only is a digital awareness-based message spread via digital ads, content placement, and influencer mentions, to name a few, but it is also targeted and relevant. Note: the most notable examples of hyper-successful brand awareness efforts include those for consumer products such as Kleenex and Q-tips. The brand awareness surrounding these products is so prevalent that we often use their brand names interchangeably with generic product names, facial tissue and cotton swabs. Branding experts often point to this development as a marketing misfire rather than the resounding success that it appears to be. After all, if I go to the store to buy some Kleenex and purchase a box of facial tissue from a competitor without batting an eyelash, what has Kleenex really achieved? Nothing in that instance, since awareness does not seem to lead to a preference for the Kleenex brand. Content marketing. Perhaps the most effective inbound marketing concept of all time, content marketing is the practice of creating, publishing, and distributing content of potential interest to targeted audiences. This content is rarely overly promotional. Instead, it is focused on providing value to audiences and stimulating interest in the relevant brand. Combined with search intent and search engine optimization principles, content marketing is one of the most effective tools in a digital marketer's toolbox. Today, content marketing is most closely associated with blogs, social media, and video content campaigns. But the concept emerged a long time ago with entrepreneur Benjamin Franklin. Franklin was a trailblazer in many disciplines. He was an inventor, a statesman, a writer, a scientist, and a civil activist. He was also a successful printer and publisher. First published in 1732, his Poor Richard's Almanac was a serial lifestyle booklet that included puzzles, stories, engaging wordplay, and other entertainment. It was a successful publication in its own right. However, it was also a valuable way for Franklin to showcase his skills as a printer and to drum up new business. This is perhaps one of the earliest examples of successful content marketing. Conversion-based marketing. Unique to the digital space, conversion-based marketing is a broad term for all the marketing efforts that go into converting internet traffic into paying customers. A dive into the numbers truly boggles the mind. Google receives more than 63,000 searches per second. That translates into roughly 5.5 billion searches per day, more than 2 trillion a year. And that's just Google. Combine social media, news sites, your favorite blogs, the list goes on. Capturing even just a tiny slice of that traffic and converting it into paying customers is the broad goal of digital marketing efforts. Digital marketers start by identifying the people who are making searches on popular search engines. Then they create content and offers that speak to solving the problems those people have, using tactics and techniques that are covered in later chapters of this book. Conversion-based marketing is laser-focused on that all-important conversion event, the point when a person on their computer, phone, or tablet, and now potentially their fridge, microwave, or washing machine, stops being merely traffic and becomes a customer. This could be the moment when the customer actually pulls out their credit card, or it could be any one of the equally important steps along the way. Due to the wealth of data available to digital marketers, conversion-based marketing efforts have the opportunity for endless tweaking, sophistication, and refinement. Conversion-based principles can be applied to digital campaigns that are based on both inbound and outbound objectives and tactics. And they are particularly well-suited to the revenue-based objectives of businesses of all sizes. In short, conversion-based marketing is the primary language of budget-minded digital marketers, meaning it is the single most utilized strategic marketing concept in the digital space right now. My take. Though they are presented separately, the aforementioned strategic approaches are, collectively, the gold standard. Using a combination of digital marketing strategies will yield the best results, rather than picking and choosing single tactics. Therefore, this book focuses primarily on using a blend of these marketing perspectives. The marketing mix. Most marketing efforts are essentially defined by the market, the media, and the message. The marketing formula. The exact way in which these elements are deployed is based on the strategic goals that marketers want to achieve. We know that marketing strategies are informed by strategic goals, but what informs those goals? Not to be confused with the marketing formula, the marketing mix is a combination of characteristics that describe exactly what it is you are selling. These characteristics help determine what shape your marketing formula should take, and therefore, what strategies make the most sense when it comes to executing marketing campaigns. Note, the marketing mix is by no means a recent concept. The term was first used by Harvard professor Neil Borden in 1953, during an address directed to the American Marketing Association. Borden said that the four components of the marketing mix, product, price, place, and promotion, impact every marketing campaign. Nearly 70 years later, it turns out that Borden is still right. The marketing mix is also commonly referred to as the four P's of marketing. The four P's are product, price, place, and promotion. They represent specific aspects that vary from product to product and are the basis for constructing and executing campaigns. Product. Your product is, literally, what you are selling. It could be a tangible product or an intangible service, but in either case, the associated product life cycle informs marketing strategy. The product life cycle of a product, or service life cycle for a service, generally consists of a series of stages that begins with introduction, progresses to growth, achieves maturity, and then moves into decline as illustrated in Figure 4. Although decline is a natural life cycle state, it can be headed off, extended, or otherwise precluded, perhaps by reigniting the life cycle all over again, beginning again with introduction. Take, for example, the launch of new iPhone models. In the space of a few years, the latest model is introduced. Sales skyrocket as millions of consumers decide to upgrade their phones. At a certain point, sales level off. And then the cycle shifts into decline as consumer interest wanes in anticipation of the next model. When the next model is announced, excitement builds again for the new introduction, and the process starts over. In the world of automobiles, each new model has a very compressed introduction and growth phase. Both start and come to conclusion within a brief period, several months before their nominal year begins. A 2021 vehicle, for example, is introduced in 2020. It hits the maturity phase during 2021 and is in decline at the point when the 2002 model is released. Trendy summer shorts or tank tops will have an even shorter product life cycle, experiencing all the life cycle stages in just a matter of weeks, quickly replaced by fall sweaters and coats. A pharmaceutical product, on the other hand, could have a life cycle that lasts a decade or more. A new drug introduced into the market enters the growth stage after a year or so, once physicians understand its benefits for their patients. It is then prescribed until demand and production level out, maturity. As other products are released and generics start grabbing market share, the drug may start to enter decline. Marketing objectives are different at each stage of the product life cycle. In the early stages of introduction and growth, it is essential to attract new customers. As the product reaches maturity, the market may not change significantly, and the media may stay the same, although the message may change and adapt.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.